You know what the fuck is going on. Every Friday fucking day, night, where the fuck it is. You just tune the fuck in. Dash Radio, the Answer More of a Show. Sandy Pants. Don't even get me started.
What's up, you guys? Welcome back to another episode of Sandy Pants on the Answer More of a Show. Today, we have two special guests. What's up, you guys?
What's happening? What's happening?
Yep.
What up? What up?
Go ahead and introduce yourselves, please.
Hola. Yo, what's up? It's Epademik. And this is...
My name is Burnzlo.
Because why? Everything burns slow. God,
yep.
God damn it. The earth.
Dinner. 100 degrees everything. Outside right now.
Fucking we're melting. I'm melting.
So tell me a little bit about background of you guys, since, you know, we have a different set of people following us, and I want my followers to get introduced to you guys.
Coming out right now with this album, DysFUNKtional. I am residing in Orange County, born in L.A., and... Man, just been grinding since early 90s, man, with this hip-hop. Just seen progression. Put out a couple albums so far, but really feel like the accumulation is this here project here where we got a funk on the menu with hip-hop. And pretty much Burnzlo is a rapper, a baller, ladies man, whatever you want to say.
That part.
But I'm here really, though, to represent the truth. And we targeting parties. I'm, happy to work with this legend right here. Epademik is the man, and I appreciate everything he's been doing as we keep this party lit. And that's pretty much it.
Me, I'm nobody special. No, what's Epademik? Gardena native, you know what the fuck it is. Eastside. But no, you know what? Been doing this music for a while. Started putting out stuff like legit, you know, back in like 98. So a little bit older, you know, but yeah, I've been doing it, been consistent. I try and drop at least a couple albums a year and singles in between, videos. So linked up with this cat a few years ago through another homeboy that's out of the Orange County area. And I said, hey, I worked on his album, helped him executive produce it. And then I want to do another project, which is the DysFUNKtional one, for the summertime. I had just finished my last album in September. And so I said, hey, he said, let's do something together. So I'm like, all right, I got this project I'm going to do. But it's all funk samples, but it's not your typical funk samples, okay? And you want to do it? He's like, yeah, let's go. So that's how we linked up. And I said, all right, boom, here's the beats. Here's like the basic skeleton tracks. Emailed it to him. Write all your stuff. So the day he came over, knocked all his stuff out in a couple hours. And then I spent the next couple months finishing everything.
Ready to go.
And then there we go. DysFUNKtional.
So this is the latest new project that boom. I have myself.
Yes.
Yes. And he actually, well, hold on. Let's open it. Well, I don't got it because, of course, it's in the car.
Right.
I still got a CD player. And you guys actually autographed these.
Yeah. So whenever I do a project, I like to do something different as far as marketing and branding. Mm-hmm. And so it's like niche marketing. So people have been bugging me for a tangible product for like the last few years. Because right. I haven't really been doing it, because that's kind of not what's happening. And so people have been bugging me, you know, fans on Japan and all over. So with this one, I said, okay, we're going to do retail-ready CDs, but we're going to number them and autograph them. Okay. And those are going to be 300. He gets 150, I get 150. And we selling them bitches for $50. You feel me? But it's all. But here's the thing. We also have the MP3 for sale for $15. You know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. We're doing promo disc for DJs and also sending the album to DJs with the instrumentals just to get that. Cause I, you know, really this project is for West Coast culture and for the true fans and supporters. If people say $50 for a CD. Okay, well, you know what? Then that's not for you. Right. You're not that fan that's supporting. That's fine. You don't even have to buy it. Like, mm-hmm. But all you can see is when you see the video that we got out. When you like it, you can be like, where do I get that song? Epademik.com or hit Burnzlo. You can't get it nowhere else. It's not out on no streaming. No, nothing. So it's a true, you know, it's like this whole niche marketing concept, which nobody's really doing. Everybody wants to hit Spotify with every 44,000 other songs a day being dropped. I'm leaving the Matrix. I'm like, no, we're gonna do this.
Yeah.
Because realistically, I'll be 100% transparent with you guys. I just got, my royalty checks for the last 3 months, right? And it was $1,000 for 3 months of music. That's nothing.
Right.
For 3 months. And then taxes, so you're $770. Yeah. Okay? Mm-hmm. So why am I only taking slivers of pennies for my music? when I can do this, sell it direct, and guess what? I've already made all my money back from this project in 2 weeks.
Wow, okay.
So leave the matrix, people. You know what I'm saying? Let your fans build you. You know, you don't need to go with all the mother people, man. Fuck all that.
Now, that doesn't mean that you can't get them. You don't have to pay $50 to hear the music. We're not trying to say that shit. Now, maybe on dysfunctional too, but the next one we call real dysfunctional. Yeah. But nah, we definitely what he said, you know what I mean? When you're into hip hop and you go, oh shit, I got to hear that. I would love to have an autographed copy from these fools. But you know what? If it don't suit you, fine. You do whatever you want, but just hear this shit. You could get an MP3s for $15. It's not even a problem. Support the source. That's all we're saying is.
Come on, local artists.
You know what? I filled up my gas tank and I spent $70. So $50. Stop playing. You're lucky we didn't charge $100.
Wow.
But I am not Nipsey Hussle the great. You know what I'm saying? So we all keep it pushing.
So I pretty much fill up the tank for today's interview.
Boom. Yeah.
That part.
So any future projects that you guys want to do after this project? Anything that you guys got worked on?
Well, I know me, I have, believe it or not, I have about 2 albums sitting. I'm just waiting. One is with this one album I've had sitting for like 8 years. It's just not, I believe in timing. And it's not. The climate of everything is, people would take it the wrong way because it's like a whole conceptual album and it's like very, it's intense. So I tend to hold on to stuff until I think, okay, the climate is good enough, because if you put something out that's not, people be like, what the fuck is this shit? Like, you know, then you just light, it's like, oh man, I just fucked that up. Right. So, I mean, I got music. I mean, he's got music. So we just, you know, hold on to shit when it's time.
We both got beats. Catalogs, a whole nine, from not only our own source but for other beat producers. But at the same time, right now we realize maximizing this moment means getting people to get into each moment that we feel, so that you get everything out of each song and every flavor that has been dished out. So it's more than just rapping. This is now psychological at this point too, trying to get people's minds to click.
Right,
when they hear it, it'll stick. And that's really what it is. You make dope shit, the dope will sell itself.
Yes.
And that's why we hear it.
Slay the dope. Buy the dope. Inhale the dope. Share the dope.
I don't know what kind of drugs they're talking about, but just make sure to pick this up. It's up Epademik on your website.
Epademik.com. Yes. Real quick, what's the replay value on that? How many times do you play it over and over?
This, I've played it. Can't even remember.
Have you skipped anything when you listen to it through?
You can't skip through this album at all. And
there
I
you
can
go.
Relate to what's the
Gang- oh, we got yeah. Oh, so yes. I got Gangsta Granny. So if anyone remember Gangsta Granny from like Dub C's albums and Ice Cube back in the 90s. So that's the big homie Jazzy, right? Shondell Rosa. And I hit him. I said, bro, I need Gangsta Granny on this project, on the intro and a skit. He's like, bro, whatever you need. So I got Gangsta Granny on here. She talking shit about her tray broke in and fuck y'all motherfuckers. And it's great. So if anyone remembers the Gangsta Granny from Dub C shit, that's the same fucking person.
That's just my favorite part of the don't tell
right.
me, favorite part of the album.
That part.
Well, I want to say thank you to both of you guys for
thank you for having us,
for coming to the show.
Yes,
and fucking with the real G.
Right.
Pardon.
Thanks for having us on.
Thank you.
Check me out at Burnzlo on Instagram if you can. My man, Epademik.com.
Yeah, Epademik.com on, go Epademik.com, and you can see me on Instagram, MC Esquire, or, you know, all that good stuff, Twitter.
DJs, get this shit. Okay. Film festival promoters, and you're going to want to put this shit on.
And one last thing, just remember, there's a lot of people on social media that may have hundreds of thousands, 30,000, 50,000, all these followers, but guess what? They're not really popping like that. So don't believe the hype. Do your own fucking diligence. Stay focused. Get your fans. All you need is 100 super fans. Like Armin has her. You get that? You get 100 Sandy Pants. Like, you know. But no, for real, y'all, that's all you need. Yeah, that's
the
all
same
you
people,
need.
That's the same people who can get 1,000 likes but don't know how to make $1,000.
Right. So you get them. You get them super fans, because a super fan is gonna tell another person. They're gonna tell everyone they talk about you. So that one super fan, they bring it in 50, and that's the game. So don't be fooled by the blue checks and all that weird shit.
We'll see you at a crowd near you.
But we have the spot like that. I'm going to send that to Armin. Look what he did.
Are you not Armin's biggest fan?
Yes.
All right. Stop lying.
Just put me on the spot.
Shout out.